स्टैंडर्ड 8, सब्जेक्ट मैथ्स, लेसन नंबर 11, स्टैटिस्टिक्स। चिल्ड्रन, इन लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड प्रैक्टिस सेट 11.1। नाउ नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज, सी, यू हैव स्टडीड बार ग्राफ इन 7th स्टैंडर्ड, ओके, एंड जॉइंट बार ग्राफ। व्हाट इज जॉइंट बार ग्राफ? सपोज दिस इज एक्स एक्सिस एंड वाई एक्सिस, ओके, एंड these are the bars. So this is called as joint bar graph, where you are showing information of girls and boys or information of men and women, okay, like two informations together in one bar, but it is joint, okay, half half you have drawn here. So this is one type, joint bar graph, okay. This type of bar graph already you have studied in 7th standard. Now this year you will study new point, that is subdivided bar graph or diagram. Now what is subdivided bar graph? See children, as in a joint bar graph, in this subdivided bar graph we can compare the information in data by a subdivided bar graph also. So children, in subdivided bar diagram, what we have to do, information of two or more constituent is given, okay, and that information we have to show in single bar, okay. See here, two small bars we are drawing for joint bar graph, okay, but here in this subdivided bar graph only one bar is there, and in that we have to show information. Suppose this is one bar and then we have to divide it according to the given conditions or given data, okay. Okay, let's study this. Which information is given here? Let's see, town, three towns, okay, and in these three towns male laborers and female laborers, number of male laborers and female laborers are given. So what we have to do here is, first we have to add both the laborers, means total laborers we have to write. So 180 plus 120 is 300. Now here 80 plus 40 is how much? 120. Then 100 plus 60 is 160. First prepare table of given data as shown above. Like this we have to prepare table. The next step is draw x-axis and y-axis on graph paper. Then write the names of towns on x-axis, keeping equal distances between two consecutive bars. Show number of laborers on y-axis with the scale 1 centimeter is equal to 40 laborers. See children, scale is very important for construction of graph. Total number of laborers in the town Itlapur is 300. Show it by a single bar. See children, this is bar graph for the given information. First what we have to do is, we have to draw x-axis and y-axis. You have to write here x and y, okay, x and y axis you have to write. Then this is point of origin. Scale, always you have to write whatever scale you are using for construction of graph, that you have to write. Already it is given in the question, in information it is given, but you have to write it on right hand side top corner of graph paper. So scale is on y-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 40 laborers. Then which symbols you are using for this? Suppose for example female white color and male blue color you are showing. Then name of towns we have to write here by keeping equal distance. See here 1 centimeter distance is left in the beginning, then on next 1 centimeter this is first town, then again 1 centimeter distance is left, then this is second town, again by keeping 1 centimeter distance next town name is written here. Then on y-axis scale is 40 labras. So 40, 80, 120 like this it is written. This is what number of labras. Now what we have to do? First town here in Ithlapur. Total how many labras are there? 300. So this is 280 and this is 320. So in between this marking is what? 300. So you have to draw this bar of 300. Then in this 300, out of this 300, how many female labras are there? 120. Okay. And how many male labras are there? 180. So see children, here you have to mark on 180. Then below this, this much is number of male labras. So you have to color it with the blue. Okay. And remaining 120 is what? Female. Similarly here in next town, Dhanodi. How many total number of labras are there? 120. So you have to draw only single bar of 120 and then you have to divide it. Subdivided means what? One only bar you have to draw and then you have to divide it. So how many number of male labras are there? Male labras are 80. So mark here 80 and then give blue color for this. Then remaining 40 is what? Female labras. Similarly, last, how many total number of labras are there? Yes, 160. Then out of this 100 male labras and remaining 60, yes, female labras are there. Okay. So whatever points we have discussed now, it is written here. Okay. Let's start practice set 11.2. Observe the following graph and answer the questions. You have to observe this graph and then you have to answer these questions. First of all, let's see what is given in the graph. Women. Yes. And on x-axis, names of few women are written here. And on y-axis, savings in rupees. Scale is what? On y-axis 1 cm is equal to 200 and savings for April and March months are given here. First question, state the type of the graph. Now look at this graph. Which type of graph it is? Yes, it is subdivided bar graph. So you have to write the answer. The given graph is subdivided bar graph. Now here I am only writing subdivided bar graph. You write full sentence. The given graph is subdivided bar graph. Okay. Second question. How much is the savings of Vaishali in the month of April? Now see. Look at this. And blue color is for April month. Okay. So now children, this blue color means what? As we have discussed, it is for April. So how much it is? See, it is 600. So how to write this answer? Write the savings of Vaishali in the month of April is rupees 600. Like this full sentence you have to write. Okay. Write question and below this question write answer in full sentence. The savings of Vaishali in the month of April is rupees 600. Next question is, how much is the total of savings of Saroj in the month of March and April? Now Saroj, see, this is bar graph which is representing Saroj's savings. So total March and April total savings is asked. So it is how much? Rupees 800, right? So the total savings here also you will write, the total savings of Saroj in the months of March and April is rupees 800. Full sentence you have to write as answer. Next is, how much more is the total savings of Savita than the total savings of Megha? Now, how much is Megha's savings? Megha's savings is rupees 500, right? It is in between 400 to 600. So, this is 500. And how much is Savita's savings? It is 1000. So, we have to find out difference. So, how to write it? 1000 minus 500. Rupees 1000 minus 500 is equal to rupees 500. So, full sentence what you will write? The total savings of Savita. Okay. Savita has rupees 500 more than Megha. Okay. Like this, final answer you have to write. Whose savings in the month of April is least? Now, in the month of April, whose saving is least? See, here it is more, 600, this is 400, this is also 400, and this is how much? 200, this is 600. So, whose it is less? It is Megha. So, the savings of Megha is the least in month of April. Okay, here I am writing only Megha, but you write full answer, full sentence. Whose it is? So, how to write answer? The savings of Megha is the least in the month of April. Now, let's move to second question. The number of boys and girls in standard 5th and standard 8th in a ZP school is given in the table. Draw a subdivided bar graph to show the data. Scale is already given here. On y-axis, 1 cm is equal to 10 students. So, whenever scale is given in the question, we have to use that scale only. If it is not given, then you can write suitable scale. Okay. Now, what information is given here? Standards 5th, 6th, 7th and 8th. Number of boys in 5th standard, 34. Number of girls, 70. Number of boys in 6th standard, 26, and number of girls, 14. 7th standard, number of boys, 21, and number of girls, 14. 8th standard, number of boys, 25, and number of girls, 20. Now, what you have to do is, here you have to represent this information by subdivided bar graph. So, you need to write one more column, one more thing here, that is total. So here you will write total, draw this table, okay, and add one extra row here and write total. So 34 plus 17 is 51, 26 plus 14 is 40, 21 plus 14 is 35, and 25 plus 20 is, see, 25 plus 20 is 45 here. Okay, so in this way you have to draw this table and write total also. Okay, see children, on graph paper, first of all, on right hand side top corner, you have to write scale. On y-axis, 1 cm is equal to 10 students. Boys we will keep blank and girls we will shade it. Okay, then see, already I have drawn here. So first of all, you have to draw x-axis. On x-axis, we will show standards 5th, 6th, 7th and 8th. First, 1 cm distance is left. Then next, 1 cm is used for 5th standard. Then again, 1 is left. Like this, alternately, we will do. This is 7. Okay. Now, on y-axis, what is written? Number of boys and girls. Scale is 10 students. Okay, 1 cm is 10 students. So, we will write here 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, like this. Okay. Now, let's start first one. How much it is? 5th standard total students, 51. So, see, this is 50. This is 50. And now, 1 cm is equal to 10 students. So, just one line above this you have to consider. So, this line, one small line we will consider, and then we will draw this bar. Now, how many number of boys and girls are there in first column? We have to show. That is for fifth standard. Fifth standard, 34 boys and 17 girls are there. So, first 17 girls we will mark here. 17 means what? Here 5, 6, 7. This line. Okay? In between 10 and 20. Okay? Now, as we have decided, and obviously if we have marked here 17, then it means remaining is how much? Remaining is number of boys, that is 34. Okay, because total already we have drawn of 51, right? So, and we have decided to shed number of girls, so we will shade it. In this way you have to do shading. Okay, you can use any symbols. You can put dots, cross lines, straight lines, horizontal lines. Okay, whatever is convenient for you, you can do it. See children, now in this way we have completed first subdivided bar. Now second information, 6th standard total 40 students are there. So this is 40. Then we'll draw bar here for 40. Now total how many number of girls are there? Number of girls are 14. So this is 10 and 14 means this 1, 2, 3, 4th line. Okay. And same like this we will shade part of this. Okay. Half part of this bar which represents number of girls. See. Okay. Now next is what? Standard 7th. Standard 7 total is 35. So here is the 35. See children, for 7th standard total 35 students are there. Out of this 35 students, again here also 14 girls are there. So same way, girls, and we will shade this part. Understood? This is very easy, but you just need to do proper calculation, and without fail you have to write down scale also. Whenever you will draw x axis and y axis, that time also write there x and y. Okay, write proper scale, because half mark is there for scale also. Now next is 8th. Total 45 students are there. So this is for 8th standard, 45 students. This is 40 and 45. Number of girls in 8th standard, 20. Okay, so we mark here 20. See children, and then we will shade this part. Okay, so this is what? For number of girls. In this way we have completed this question number 2. Okay, draw the table and below the given information write down total. Okay, and in this way you have to draw graph. Next, question number 3. In the following table, number of trees planted in the year 2016 and 2017 in 4 towns is given. Show the data with the help of subdivided bar graph. See names of towns written here and years. Similarly, same like question number 2, here also we have to write total. So while writing in your notebook, draw this table as it is and write down total also. So for Karzat in 2016, how many trees planted? 150. And 2017, 200. So total is 350. In Wadgaon, 250 plus 300, total 550. Shivapur, total 200 plus 250, that is 450. And Khandala, 100 plus 150, that is 250. See children, first of all you have to write down scale. On y-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 100 saplings. Now in this question, scale is not given, but whatever is suitable we can take. So write on y-axis, 1 centimeter is equal to 100 saplings. For 2016 we will put cross markings like this, and 2017 we will leave blank as it is. Okay, see, this is x-axis, it is written here x-axis, and on this names of towns are written. This is origin, point of origin. Okay, first 1 centimeter distance is left, then first town which is given in the table is Karzat, then Wadgaon, Shivapur and Khandala. Then on y-axis, after drawing y-axis, write your y. You have to write this x and y here. Okay, then on y-axis what is written? Number of saplings, and scale 100, 200. Okay, 1 centimeter is equal to 100 is the scale. So on y-axis you have to write 100, 200, 300, 400, these numbers. Okay, see children, now for Karzat, how much is the total? Total is now 350. Okay, so first we will draw bar on 350. See children, now this is first bar for Karzat. Now in 2017 200 trees were planted, so we will mark here on 200. Okay, so remaining 150 is for what? 2016. So this we have to shade. Now for 2016 we have decided to put cross marks. So this 150 we have to see like this. Okay, now second is Wadgaon. Total is how much? 550. Okay, so 550 means up to this. First of all draw bar here on 550, and then in 2017 300 trees were planted, so this is 300, and remaining 250 is of 2016. So again here also this 2016 we will put cross mark for this. This symbols also, whatever you are shading for whichever information, these symbols also you have to mention in the scale, below the scale. Next is Shivapur. In Shivapur total 450. Total is 450. See, total is 450. Out of this 450, 250 is number of trees planted in 2017. So remaining 200 is for what? 2016. So we will shade it. Last one, Khandala. खंडाला टोटल नंबर ऑफ ट्रीज 250. आउट ऑफ दिस 250 150 ट्रीज प्लांटेड इन 2017. सो दिस इज 150 एंड रिमेनिंग 100 ट्रीज आर प्लांटेड इन 2016, which we have to shade with the cross lines. Okay, see, in this way we have completed question number 3. Now question number 4. In the following table, data of the transport means used by students in 8th standard for commutation between home and school is given. Okay, draw a subdivided bar diagram to show the data. Scale on y-axis 1 cm is equal to 500 students. Okay, towns Paithan, Yewla and Shahapur. Means of commutation is cycle, bus and auto, or on foot. Okay, here also we have to write total. See, 3250 plus 750 plus 1000, total is 5000. 1500 plus 500 plus 1000 is 3000. Shahapur, 1250 plus 500 plus 500, total is 2250. So while drawing in notebook, you have to draw this full table as it is. Write total also. Okay. Now let's solve this. Scale is already given here. See children, whichever scale is given in the question, you have to write it. Scale on y-axis 1 cm is equal to 500 students. Now we have to use 3 different symbols, because 3 different informations we have to show in one bar. So on foot we will keep blank. Bus and auto we will put cross marks, and for cycle now, okay, we will shade it. Now same like question number 2 and 3, draw x-axis. On x-axis you have to write names of towns Paithan, Yewla and Shahapur. Then on y-axis means of commutation by students. Scale is what? 500. 1 centimeter is equal to 500 students. So 500, 1000, 1500, like this numbers you will write on y-axis. So let's start. First one is Paithan. Now what is the total? Total is 5000. First total is 5000. So we will draw this. First bar of 5000. Okay. Then out of this 5000, 1000 is what? On foot. Number of students. Now let's start with the cycle first. How many students are using cycle? 3250. So here is a 3000 and this is 3500. So in between what will come? 3200. See children, now this is 3250. Then next is 750 students, those who use bus and auto. So this is distance of remaining 250 students, and this is 500. So total is how much? 750. So next marking will come on 4000, right? 3250 plus 750 is how much? 4000. So next will come on 4000, and then last 1000 is what? Yes, on foot. Now according to the shading which we have decided, we will shade it. First one is what? on cycle. So we have decided to shade it like this. See, this way. And then next part is bus and auto. So we will shade it like this. And remaining we will keep blank, that is on foot. See, whatever we have decided here, according to this we have done. Now next town is Yewla. Okay, total number of students 3000. So first we will draw bar. Okay, this bar we will draw first, 3000. See, now in this also students, those who use cycle, how much it is? 1500, right? 1500. So here we'll mark first. Then next students, those who go by bus or auto is 500. So this 1500 plus 500, that is 2000. So we'll mark next year. Okay, and remaining is what? Remaining 1000 is on foot. So same like this, we will shade this also. Then for bus and auto, like this cross markings. In this, what is important is just you need to do proper calculation. Okay, don't get confused, do proper calculation. See here, first 1500 which we have shown is students those who use cycle. Then student those who use bus or auto. Okay, those who go by bus or auto, only 500. So one bar, remaining one bar. And then last 1000 is what? Students those who go by walking. Next town is Shahpur. Total is 2250. So we'll draw a bar for this. 2250. Okay, then here 1250 students, this is 1000 and this is 1250 students go by cycle. Okay, and 500 students go by bus or auto and 500 by walk, right? So here now you need to count, because this remaining 1000 we have to show bus and auto, of 500 students for bus and auto and 500 students for those who go by walk. So this is 250 plus this 250. This is total 500, right? And remaining is 500, correct? So it will come in between the remaining distance. Okay, in this way we have completed this practice set. Children, I will send you photos of this bar graph paper, full photo I will send on group, so that there will be no confusion. Okay, in this way we have completed this practice set 11.2.